Почитувани гледачи, наш денешен специјален гостин е еден од најпопуларните личности на политичката сцена, но не е политичар. Станува збор за човек кој речи си секојдневно се сретнуваше со политичарите, имаше преговори со часови на една единствена тема, а тоа е исполнување на договорот од Пржина, господинот Питер Ван Хаута. Good evening.
Good evening.
How are you?
I'm doing well.
Do you know that you are very popular among Macedonian people?
I realize that, of course, when I go around, people approach me, they want to make selfies with me and so on. I went to Kumanovo, Tetovo, and it's everywhere the same. What is, however, important, it's not about me, it's about the message, it's about the substance, I would say. This is what really matters. And I'm very glad that many people start getting it and want to go for change.
Mr. Van Houten, you came in Macedonia to help political parties to solve the crisis. You were here in 2001, you came again. Is Macedonia changed from 2001 till now? I'm not talking about architectural look of our city.
It changed a lot, I would say. Today,
in
I observe, when I meet people, I observe a climate of fear. People are afraid of everything. They are afraid to lose their jobs. They are afraid to be fired. They are afraid if they don't obey certain political parties that they might have consequences for them. This is not what we call a democratic, free, democratic climate. That's very bad.
How can we solve that?
I would say you need new people, you need fresh people, maybe even new political parties coming into and participating in elections. You need some alternative, and people need to be aware, yes, there is an alternative to the current situation.
Do you believe that there will be elections on 5th of June?
It's one thing whether there will be elections the 5th of June. It's another thing how they will be organized. Today I see that there is a lot of pressure on media. The media are not balanced. I'm not talking about you, but in general. There is a huge problem with the voter registry. We try to minimize the problem now within the State Election Commission by trying to do the minimum that we can do there, but this is not really good enough. In the end, the system should be one citizen, one vote. And everything that is not there to build sufficient trust that the people know, it will be respected this principle, one citizen, one vote, then it is problematic. Then you better don't have elections.
What is your opinion about those 100,000 people that are going to be checked from door to door?
It's not enough. I would like the State Election Commission to check thoroughly all complaints and all possible problems in the voter registry. It will take more time, but that's what your people deserve. You cannot have free and fair elections if you don't have a really, truly clean voter registry.
You said politicians, parties have to learn how to negotiate, and even then we can expect some progress. You came to negotiate, did they learn something?
I think they learned something, but not enough. There are two things that are important in negotiations. First of all, you need to listen to each other, and secondly, you need to be able to get to a compromise. You cannot win it all, you cannot take it all, like they are used to do it here. You have to give in to make a workable compromise in the end and to agree on the future of the country.
Do you believe that Kati Cajaneva can become new Laura Kövesi?
Let's wait and see what's going to happen there. I think we should give her the time and all support that she needs and can get to do this very difficult job and to bring it to an end.
You said that it's not good to copy-paste European laws because we have different mentality, different culture. How can we solve that problem?
What the EU requests you to do is not to copy and paste legislation, but to harmonize legislation. Mm-hmm. You have your own legal framework, you have your own laws. What you need to do is to revise them and bring them in line with the European standards and the European directives and laws that we have in Europe. That's all you need to do. It's as simple as that.
We have a lot of laws that are really copying from Europe, but they don't function here.
Because there's no implementation and no one is overseeing and monitoring the implementation of your legislation. I see it in the judiciary, I see it in the educational system. This is very, very problematic. And I think we as internationals, we need to engage much more in monitoring how the legislation is implemented.
You had negotiation with political parties for months. What is your opinion? What is your reaction when you realize that the journalists are staying in front of Parliament Club and waiting for hours for statement?
As a former journalist, I'm sometimes a bit disappointed. I know that you have to respect the media as well. You have to communicate. Being silent is not a good option. And in the end, the people have the right to know what's going on inside the parliamentary club. They have the right to know what the politicians do. This is very important, I would say.
Does political parties tell the truth when they give a statement to the journalist?
Sometimes yes, often not really. They have their own ideas, they have their own positions, they have their own vision on certain problems, which is good, I would say. But where things go bad is that inside the parliamentary club, when we had discussions, I regretted that only SDSM was the only party who from time to time invited experts to participate in the discussions. None of the other parties ever did this. You cannot have politicians who know everything. Even if they claim they know everything about everything, this is really not the case. The debate would have been much better if they would have brought in experts as well to support the process.
Can you shortly tell us what was happening inside? Can you give us some picture? We want to know what's going on inside, but no one tells us. What the meetings look like?
In general, I would say waiting, waiting, waiting. Sometimes we had to wait for an hour and a half before we could even start the meeting because one of the parties didn't show up. Usually the parties in the ruling coalitions were the most, in the ruling coalition were the most problematic in this regard. They were late. Only DPA was the only party always strictly on time. When you said 8 o'clock, they were there 8 o'clock. Was it 9 o'clock, they were there 9 o'clock. But for the other parties, much more relaxed. The second problem in the political working group was that basically the discussion was sometimes heated, often impolite as well. People were not always behaving the way it should be in normal negotiations. And what you see is that at some point Vumero left the negotiations and we continued with three parties. And then the whole atmosphere cleared out and it was a much different debate, much more constructive. Yes, with three parties, we managed to reach, in a few hours, a good agreement on media issues. But the problem is, of course, when the fourth party came back, this whole agreement was immediately destroyed.
What was the difference between Vamaros and Sasama's suggestion on media reforms?
The core issue of the media is the control over the media. The regulatory agency, the AVMS agency, plays a key role in this. If you are not able to take the party control out of this agency and to allow independent people to professionally do their job, there is no reason why we should discuss any other changes in media legislation. And this was the main difference between me, between the international community and Vumero and SDSM on the other side.
Do you think that this problem will be solved? The media problem?
No, this problem will not be solved. There might be some marginal problems that might be solved related to the financing of Marutte, the public radio broadcaster, but that's as far as it goes. But the real issue, the underlying issue, is the issue of party control. We cannot allow in a democratic society that parties control the media.
Vumero, the parliament said that you offended Macedonian citizen and that's why they left the negotiation. What's your comment on that?
If you don't like the message, of course, kill the messenger. That's what I always say. So you blame the messenger for everything that goes wrong. They should realize and reconsider their options. I think it is extremely important that finally they understand that in a democratic world, it's not up to you to control the media. You have to allow an open space. You have to allow people to think freely, to say what they want to say, and to deal with the people and to listen to the experts to provide you advice on what you need to do.
Are politicians stubborn?
Sometimes very stubborn. Stubbornness can be a quality, but it's often also an obstacle. If you're not open to listen to anyone else's comments or suggestions or advice, then yes, there is a problem. And that's what I see here today.
And how can we solve everything?
I think people should, whenever there will be elections, people should reconsider the different options and vote for those parties who might be able to make a difference. I'm not sure for the moment that we have these parties. But that's what people need to consider, of course.
But you said that people are afraid they're going to lose their job.
I'm collecting stories over the last couple of weeks, and I can tell you, out of the hundreds of people I met, ordinary people, farmers, people working in hospitals, people teaching at the universities, teachers at schools, all of them, one thing is very important, they are all afraid to lose their job if they don't do what they are told to do by the party.
Do you have hard feelings that when Vomero Depomena said that you are just tourist for them?
No, as a professional, I don't have any hard feelings. I have my own ideas about it. I'm very happy to be a tourist in this country. I don't have any problem with that. But they should realize that one day they will be back around the negotiation table, maybe not with me, but with other people, and the conditions will be much, much tougher than they were today.
Did you visit Museum of Vomero?
No, and I have to, I'm still considering my options, but you have so much more beautiful museums, like the Museum for Modern Art and so on. There is a beautiful gallery with modern art as well. I prefer to visit these museums first and then look into, and then finally probably go to the Vomero Museum as well.
If you had a chance to write something on the paper, what will it be?
We are working on something. It's very good that people realize that this is also part of the history, and it is very important that people learn to look forwards. And I'm willing to look and to engage in the coming months also in a process of supporting people, critical people, to develop a strategy on what do we need to do in order to solve the actual problems. That's what really matters. That's where we can make the difference and where we should make the difference.
What do you think? That Macedonian politicians should go with bicycle and work? Or we have to wait for hours for them to cross?
I think they should learn to use a bicycle, because that way you are closer to the people, you listen to the people, you have the way to, it's a way of interacting with the people on the streets. And maybe that might change their mindset as well and make them more accessible to the people and to the requests of the people and the real concerns of the people on the ground.
And one last question.
Yes,
what is the cat? You became very popular with the cat Mehmet.
You remember when we had a tragic terrorist attack some time ago in Brussels, and there was a lot of activity ongoing. Then the police asked all citizens, like they probably will do today, to refrain from commenting on Twitter from what they saw on the street or in their neighborhood. And then people start using cats and tweeting them around. Belgians, we have a tradition of being surrealistic. We have some famous painters, surrealist painters as well. So I said, if you can't say the truth anymore bluntly, openly, let's rely on the cats. Let them tell the truth.
Почитувани, тоа беше господинот Питер Ван Хаута, гостин во специјалното издание на ТВ21. Останете со нас.